This is the Celestron StarSense Explorer Dob, an 8-inch visual telescope with an innovative smartphone app to help you locate objects in the night sky. This telescope has enough power to not only see the planets up close, but also distant deep sky objects such as galaxies and nebulae. In this video, I'll show you how the StarSense Explorer Dob works and explain why I think it's a great option for beginners that are looking for a little help in locating objects in the night sky. Oh, and yes, you can do astrophotography with a manual Dobsonian telescope like this, just on a very simple level of the brightest objects. Plus, your phone is actually kind of already in use, but I'll explain everything, just keep watching. Celestron sent me a demo version of their 8-inch model, a full 2 inches smaller than the version they sent Ed Ting. Probably for the best, he really knows his stuff. The timing of this video is okay. There's about 3 to 4 hours of forecasted clear sky time tonight. The problem is it's also going to be minus 11 degrees Celsius with snow on the ground. So I hope that when you get a chance to use this telescope, it's a little nicer outside. Unlike a lot of the astrophotography I typically do on this channel where I am sitting at a computer screen, a telescope like this is meant to be enjoyed outside at the eyepiece. An 8-inch Dobsonian telescope is arguably the best first telescope for those new to astronomy. It has enough aperture to provide some great views, they're easy to use, and they're affordable. There's a big mirror in there, a full 8 inches of aperture. By comparison, an 8-inch mirror provides 78% more light than a 6-inch, which means more deep sky objects like galaxies and nebulae are available to you in the night sky, not just the planets and the moon. This is considered to be a push-to telescope because everything is done manually. You do all the pointing. But this one gives you some help. Using the innovative StarSense plate solving technology, you have an advantage over the old school star hoppers. There are two main components to this package, the 8-inch Dobsonian telescope itself, and then the StarSense Explorer docking system and smartphone app. You can, of course, just use this telescope on its own without the app, it's a great scope, and then start using that StarSense system when you're ready. The telescope itself is nothing too special. It's an 8-inch Newtonian reflector sitting on a Dobsonian base. As I said, this is the 8-inch version, which provides a native focal length of 1200 millimeters at f5.9. That's enough reach to get a good look at Saturn's rings or Jupiter's moons using a high-powered eyepiece. Speaking of eyepieces, this package includes an 1.25 inch 25 millimeter Plossel Celestron Omni eyepiece. This is a perfect mid-range all-purpose eyepiece, but you can of course use your existing 1.25 inch or 2 inch eyepieces on this scope. I'm told that the 10-inch model has some balancing issues, particularly when using a heavy eyepiece at the front of the scope. As you can see, it's a non-issue on the 8-inch model, but that's probably because I like to really stiffen the tension knobs on my Dobs. I don't want it moving anywhere in the wind, and this is very, very secure. The front of the tube is also where you install the included red dot finder. You know what, in the past I've said that red dot finders suck, but they actually don't. Yeah, it's a lot more fun to look through a quality 8x50 finder scope, but these things do their job. They're all function, no frill. Even though I have never, not once, ever remembered to turn the red dot finder off when I'm done with it. The 8-inch version is probably the best fit for most people as it's more manageable than the larger 10-inch model. If you want even more light gathering power, by all means, go for the 10, but that one is a heavy beast. The one you see here is about 50 pounds in total, so for most people, it's best to carry it in two parts when transporting it around. Not me, however, the whole kit and caboodle at once. If you're like me and treat your back like a piece of industrial farm equipment, you'll appreciate the big handles on it to get the job done. You have to put together the big Dobsonian base yourself, the rocker box. This process takes about 30 minutes to an hour. All the tools that you need are provided, but it's probably the least fun part of the entire experience. Trust me, I've built 4 of these things now. While you're putting the base together, you should download the Celestron StarSense Explorer app on your phone. It's a big download, and when it's done, you'll need to enter the unique code that Celestron sends you along with the scope. The optical tube itself comes fully assembled, so all you need to do there is place it into the rocker box. The StarSense system involves an odd-looking bracket mounted to the scope where you would normally see a finder scope, only this one has an angled mirror. There's a big plastic cover that comes onto the dock, which is probably a good idea to put back on when you're done to avoid getting too much dust on that mirror. At first, I didn't know what I was looking at, but this is where you will place your phone looking into that mirror to take pictures and analyze the telescope's location in the night sky. If you've used a smartphone adapter to take pictures through your telescope before like I have, this setup might look a little confusing. Yes, there's a smartphone adapter there, but it is not looking through the eyepiece. So if you want to take pictures through your smartphone from the eyepiece while using the StarSense Explorer app on your phone, you'll need a second smartphone adapter and a second phone. Okay, let's talk about the StarSense system and how it works. Place your phone on the StarSense dock and then use the intuitive controls on the adapter to line up the camera lens on your phone with that mirror. There's a setup wizard in the app that walks you through the entire process. And remember, this isn't really a live view, but short exposure pictures, so there's a bit of a delay in when you turn that on to when you'll see the first image. The mirror in the bracket reflects the direction your telescope is pointed into the camera lens on your phone. It's not looking through the telescope at all, just wide out in the open. You need to point the telescope towards a distant object like a telephone pole or a tree, and then use the crosshairs in the app to make sure it's centered with the same object you're seeing through your eyepiece. Yep, you're just pinching and zooming to get that crosshair aligned on the same target. This felt really weird because, as you know, a traditional finder scope, you actually have to move the scope around, but not this time. Just the crosshairs, the software knows. Once it gets dark out, it will use this pointing information to plate solve star patterns in the night sky and determine your telescope's exact position. Getting all of this set up in terms of the smartphone app and my phone was relatively easy to do at dusk. That's when I recommend you do it. Some of you will find this process kind of cool and exciting like I did. Others, I think, will face some trial and error, but you'll get it eventually, trust me. The biggest adjustment I had to make here, and this is something to consider, is that you now need to leave your smartphone in this position in the StarSense dock for the entire imaging session. You can no longer use your phone for anything else because it has to stay there. Yeah, so that's not actually true. You can still swap between apps on your phone. I actually ran my imaging session on my ASI Air while the phone was still docked. It's not ideal, but you can still use your phone. Actually, I even took the phone out of the dock, used it for a few things, put it back in carefully, and it retained its plate solving capabilities and its original position and alignment. So, good to know. The Celestron StarSense app can really drain your battery doing all that plate solving computation in there. So it's best to have it plugged into a portable battery pack if possible to keep the phone going all night. Celestron sent me their little flashlight / battery charger along with this setup, and that's an ideal accessory for a setup like this. Okay, now that the telescope and the StarSense system are aligned and ready to go, we can start enjoying the guided experience it provides. The on-screen star map is really slick, and it's a lot of fun to move the telescope towards your object. The arrows tell you which way you need to move the telescope, and when you finally reach your target, the crosshair will turn green. I was pretty impressed with how well the system works and that the object I wanted to see was right there in the eyepiece. First try. There's a reason that Celestron decided to expand the StarSense system into their line of Dobs. It's because it's a proven system that works and it's a lot of fun. Beginners can now bang off dozens of objects in the night sky on a single observing session thanks to this simple system that uses a device they already own, their phone. Okay, now for astrophotography. Seeing as how this is a fully manual, non-tracking Dobsonian telescope mount, long exposure deep sky astrophotography is completely out of the question. However, the big aperture of this telescope means a bright image at the eyepiece. This will make taking pictures of the moon and the brightest planets possible. For the best results, use a smartphone adapter that can hold your phone securely up against that eyepiece. Even then, it will be really tricky because essentially you're pointed at a moving target. However, that's not to say that it just can't be done. You've probably heard people say you just can't do astrophotography with a Dobsonian telescope. But I don't know, taking your first shot of the moon or the planet Saturn through the eyepiece of your Dobsonian telescope is still astrophotography. It's just the starting point. My first image of the Orion Nebula was taken through a manual Dobsonian telescope, and well, you know the way the rest of that story goes. There have been numerous attempts by these astronomy manufacturers to add a go-to or hybrid functionality to a manual Dobsonian telescope in the past. Tools to help you avoid the I have no idea how to find anything scenario. Some of them took off, others didn't. The difference this time is the StarSense system uses your own phone as the technology component, saving you the cost of bolting on an additional piece of hardware with the computing power. If you're a visual observing purist, I doubt you'll want to employ a system that has you looking at your phone for long periods of time. Yes, the app has a night mode to preserve your night vision, but a completely screen-free observing session is an entirely different experience. However, those of you that have your heart set on astrophotography in the future, I doubt that this element of tech will deter you from using it. And you'll even get a sneak peek into the amazing power of plate solving, something I personally didn't explore for way too long. If you're in the market for a beginner telescope that nearly guarantees a positive first experience, an 8-inch Dobsonian telescope continues to be one of the best options available. If adding an additional layer of guidance via your smartphone is worth it to you, then the StarSense Explorer Dob is an incredible value. This telescope makes astronomy more approachable to beginners and gets them to that first point of victory sooner. And that's a special thing. Okay, that's all I've got. Thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, clear skies.